Ranked battles are a game mode that enables eligible players to enter a matchmaking queue against one another. Every victory helps to raise your rank, and defeats can reduce your rank. To access a ranked battle, you'll use the drop-down menu to the right of the battle button within the port. To check your current rank, and to see the various rewards offered for achieving certain ranks, you can access the profile tab within the port. Simply select the ranks option that appears on the left-hand side of the screen to reveal your progress.
Konigsberg was a German light cruiser that was operated between 1929 and April 1940, including service in World War II. She was the lead vessel of her class and was operated by two German navies, the Reichsmarine and the Kriegsmarine. She had two sister ships, Karlsruhe and Köln. Konigsberg was built by the Kriegsmarinewerft in Wilhelmshaven. She was laid down in April 1926, launched in March 1927, and commissioned into the Reichsmarine in April 1929. She was armed with a main battery of 9 15-centimeter SKC/25 guns in three triple turrets and had a top speed of 32 knots, 59 kilometers per hour, 37 miles per hour. Konigsberg served as a training ship for naval cadets throughout the 1930s, and joined the non-intervention patrols during the Spanish Civil War in the late 1930s. After the outbreak of World War II in September 1939, she laid defensive minefields in the North Sea and then participated in Operation Weserübung, the invasion of Norway in April 1940. While attacking Bergen, she was badly damaged by Norwegian coastal artillery, and sunk by British bombers the following day in the harbor. The wreck was eventually raised in 1942 and broken up for scrap the following year. Konigsberg was ordered as Cruiser B and given the temporary name Ersatz Thetis, since she was intended to replace the old cruiser Thetis. She was laid down at the Kriegsmarinewerft in Wilhelmshaven on the 12th of April 1926 and launched on the 26th of March 1927. She was commissioned into the Reichsmarine on the 17th of April 1929. After her commissioning, the ship was assigned as the flagship of the reconnaissance force for the German fleet. She thereafter conducted a series of training cruises for naval cadets and made numerous goodwill visits throughout the Mediterranean Sea. In 1931, the ship's first major modification took place. Her foremast was shortened and her rear superstructure was slightly lengthened. Otto von Schrader commanded the ship from September 1931 to September 1934. Hubert Schmundt relieved him and served as the ship's captain for the following year. In 1934, a pair of 8.8 centimeters, 3.5 in, anti-aircraft guns in individual mounts were installed on her aft superstructure just forward of her main battery turrets. That same year, she and the cruiser Leipzig made the first goodwill visit to the United Kingdom since the end of World War I 16 years earlier. In 1935, the ship had an aircraft catapult installed, along with a crane to handle float planes. The following year, the single 8.8 centimeters guns were replaced with a new triaxially stabilized twin mount. Two other twin mounts were added on the rear superstructure. Fire control directors for the anti-aircraft guns were also installed. After emerging from this refit, Konigsberg was employed as a gunnery training ship. During the Spanish Civil War in the late 1930s, the ship participated in non-intervention patrols, during which he forced Republicans to surrender a German freighter they had seized. After returning to Germany, Konigsberg resumed her gunnery training duties, and also served as a testbed for radar prototypes. She was scheduled to be transferred to the U-boat school, where she would be used as a target ship for U-boat crews. This duty was interrupted by the outbreak of World War II in September 1939. One day before the German invasion of Poland, on the 31st of August, Konigsberg spotted the Polish destroyers Bursa and Bliskowica in the Baltic. At the start of hostilities, she and several other German cruisers laid a defensive minefield in the North Sea. She then went into the Baltic Sea for training maneuvers. Kurt Caesar Hoffmann served as the ship's captain from June to September 1939. In late 1939, a degaussing coil was installed on the ship's hull. Konigsberg returned to active duty in March 1940, when she was assigned to the invasion force for the attack on Norway. The invasion of Norway took place in early April 1940. Konigsberg was assigned to Group 3, and was tasked with transporting 600 troops from the Wehrmacht's 69th Infantry Division from Wilhelmshaven to Bergen, Norway. Group 3 also included her sister ship Köln, the artillery training ship Reims, and the torpedo boats Wolf and Leopard. The Germans left Wilhelmshaven on the 8th of April, and had reached their target the following day, where Konigsberg transferred part of the landing party to several smaller vessels. She then made a high-speed run into the port in an attempt to land the remainder of the infantry in the town directly. A 21 centimeters, 8.3 inch, coastal battery at the Kvarven fort took the ship under fire, and scored three hits, all forward. The hits caused severe flooding and fires in her boiler rooms that cut the ship's power. Adrift, and unable to maneuver, Konigsberg had to drop anchor, while she and Köln looked after their bombers, and the infantry neutralized the Norwegian guns. Konigsberg required major repairs before she would be able to return to Germany, so she was temporarily moored in the harbor with her broadside facing the harbor entrance. This would allow her to bring all of her main battery guns to bear against any British naval attack. The rest of Group 3 returned to Germany. On the evening of the 9th of April, she was attacked by British bombers, but to no effect. The following morning, the British launched another air raid on the ship. The raid consisted of 16 Blackburn Skua dive bombers of the British Fleet Air Arm, 7 of 800 Naval Air Squadron and 9 of 803 Naval Air Squadron, launched from Nashatston, Orkney. Konigsberg's thin deck armor rendered her quite vulnerable to dive bomber attack. The skuas attacked in three groups, the 9 of 803 NAS, 6 of 800 NAS, and one aircraft of 800 NAS which lost contact during the outward flight but found Konigsberg independently. The dive bombers attacked at 7:20, catching the ship's crew off guard. Half of the dive bombers had completed their dives before the crew realized they were under attack. Only one large anti-aircraft gun was reported as being manned, with shells being fired once every 5 seconds from the aft of the ship, with lighter anti-air weapons firing from the shore and adjacent ships firing even later in the attack. Konigsberg was hit by at least 5 100-pound, 45 kilograms, bombs, which caused serious damage to the ship. One penetrated her thin deck armor, went through the ship, and exploded in the water, causing significant structural damage. Another hit destroyed the auxiliary boiler room. Two more bombs exploded in the water next to the ship, the concussion from the blasts tore large holes in the hull. She took on a heavy list almost immediately, and the captain ordered the crew to abandon the ship. It took slightly less than 3 hours from the start of the attack for the ship to completely capsize and sink, which gave the crew enough time to evacuate many of the dead and wounded. They also had time to remove a significant amount of ammunition and equipment from the stricken cruiser. Only 18 men were killed in the attack. The wreck was raised on the 17th of July 1942, and slowly broken up for scrap thereafter. By 1943, the wreck had been completely dismantled in situ.
In terms of gameplay, Konigsberg is perhaps one of the strongest cruisers in her tier. The ability to drop torpedoes, hit hard with cannons, and maneuver gives her a clear advantage over the previous tier 5 Terror, the Omaha. The Konigsberg is a better ship in every way. Players should consider seeing a Konigsberg on field as an immediate threat that should be avoided or removed as soon as possible. But it does have thin armor, and in any battle where tier 6 cruisers are present, you have to watch out not getting caught by surprise and receive a full volley into the broadside. The Konigsberg is a fantastic ship to play in the hands of a seasoned cruiser captain. Her speed and firepower and stupid good range make her a great ship in the hands of a skilled player. In the hands of a new player, or someone who doesn't play cruisers primarily, it will range from average experiences to absolute nightmares. Many players will pick up this boat and play a few games and will most of the time be one of the first ships killed. A cruiser is a ship with very little to no armor. Expect to take large amounts of crippling damage when you take a hit from a large surface warship. The Konigsberg is a ship that is best used at medium to long range. 16 kilometers range with 8.9 rounds a minute means you should be sniping at cruisers and smaller vessels, and harassing battleships from long range with when they are engaged with other targets. With advanced fire training, your max range is a hilarious 19.8 kilometers, meaning you outrange most ships save the Congo at your tier. You are a second line ship, meaning you follow behind the battleships and other cruisers. Your speed and rapid firing guns also makes you perfect for destroyer hunting. Many a destroyer have thought they can take down a Konigsberg because of its weak armor. When kiting and an eye on his torpedoes, you can easily dodge his spread and hunt him down. This does require a strong situation awareness though, as when your back is turned, a BB cannon will sometimes put a salvo into you from range. When you get close with the Konigsberg, it's important to show as little of your side as possible. Remember the golden rule: side equals death and you'll be fine. The Konigsberg and its odd turret arrangement in some cases can work to your favor. When kiting with the ship, the middle to rear turret actually closes in tighter than other ships, meaning you bring more guns to bear with as little of side show as possible. Only broadside as a last resort, in cases where you know a full salvo will kill your foe. It is paramount you know where the citadels of enemy cruisers are, because you rarely get a second chance.
Thank you. Thank you.